And we are back with topics. First thing we're going to talk about are the GameStop stocks. Now, this is an interesting story, and to help us break it down, I have a little snippet from a CNET article that kind of explains it, and then we'll let Michael kind of get into it because he seems to be a little more researched when it comes to this kind of stuff. Anyway, take it away, Callie.
Effectively, the Wall Street Bets crowd created artificial demand for GameStop and BlackBerry shares with their own money. There are 2.2 million members of the Wall Street Bets community, though it's nearly impossible to determine how many people are involved in the GameStop and BlackBerry schemes. What happens is that by buying a lot of GameStop shares quickly, the price rises. That's normal. With GameStop, though, there are also a lot of short sellers, or people who effectively bet the stock will drop rather than rise. But there's a hitch. If GameStop's price rises too much too quickly, short sellers, the people who are betting on GameStop struggles, are forced to buy even more stock to cover their losses. That pushes the stock up even more. That's how we suddenly see GameStop's value jump.
I guess I have experience in this realm from my background in political work, whatever. I mean, I guess some background for those listening who might not be familiar with any of this at all is that short selling is essentially, the basis is I'm going to bet that this stock of this company is going to fall dramatically. So what you do is you borrow stock at the price it's at, and then you sell it. So for example, if I buy a stock, or I borrow a stock that's worth $10 and I sell it, I have $10, and then you bet on that price dropping. So if the price drops to $5, you buy that stock back and you give it back to the person you borrowed it from. And then now that's only worth $5. So to buy it back, it's only $5, but you get to keep the change. That is what short selling is. And obviously scale that to the millions and motherfuckers make money. And the thing is that technically, it's not sanctioned by like the SEC or whatever, the Securities Exchanges Commission, who's supposed to regulate financial markets. So that's where hedge funds come in. And hedge funds do a lot of different things. And one of them is basically giving folks a easy path to do short selling. That is a big part of what hedge funds do, is like, hey, you want a short sell? Shit, come on board. But also hedge funds are very exclusive. So to be even in conversations with folks who run hedge funds, you sort of need to prove yourself. It's kind of like the Yakuza or like a gang. You need to get jumped
back
in.
To the Yakuza.
You need to get jumped in. And if you don't have like the financial standing, if you don't got the clout, then you don't get jumped into a hedge fund, and you can't participate. And they can do this because hedge funds are not subject to SEC regulations. So that's why short selling exists in the first place. And then so with GameStop, it's like when the pandemic hit, I mean, you could ask anyone and be like, yo, is GameSpot, GameSpot's not gonna tank. We are fucking killing it. GameStop, you asked me in April last year, is GameStop gonna tank? Like, yeah, probably, yeah. I would bet here's the thing. It's like, I would bet hella money that it would tank. That's what that's folks who are involved with short selling said the same thing. And then so when they are betting on, like, they did their short selling business, you know, borrowing stocks and then selling high and then buying back low, which is the opposite of actual investing. So then when Wall Street Bets basically says, no, we are going to use collective action to buy up stocks, drive up the price. So you motherfuckers who was trying to make money off of GameStop tanking, now those, because short selling has to do with borrowing. So those stocks that you're dealing with aren't yours. And then when those prices go up and you have to return those borrowed stocks to the person that lent it to you, it's like, oh fuck, that those $10 that I borrowed from you, that shit's actually worth like $50 now. How am I gonna pay back that $50 that you're asking for now? And then it's like, yo, and then you scale that to the millions. That's where the, like, Melvin Capital, which is one of the hedge funds who were involved with GameStop, like, that's why they fucked up.
Reddit truly said power to the players.
They said they said seize the memes. This is like meme stocks, like real talk. And then so basically what this is what I want folks to take away from this is to show the power of collective action, because that is essentially what Wall Street Bets, the subreddit, did. It's like, oh, we got millions of, what, I guess like 2.2 million members. I don't think every member of that subreddit participated or is participating in this. But what that tells me is like, look, at the damage you did to the financial institution with collective action. So like, take the lesson of how powerful collective action is and then put it into other shit too. Like, I don't know, like,
do you think the government's gonna crack down on this type of action? Because I know like it kind of is illegal for like a bunch of people to band together and yeah, do that, but like what a lot of people posted on Twitter was like, I bet you that the government will take more action on this than they did with all of those politicians and people who sold off all their hotel stock right before the pandemic, yeah, when they learned that all these travel shutdowns would happen. And that, depressingly, I could 100% see that happening, like shutting down that Reddit subreddit or whatever. And like,
yeah, I definitely feel what you're saying. Like, oh, they're gonna act now. I don't, that is a genuine concern. Obviously, I don't have the answers. If I did, I'd be making a whole lot more motherfucking money right now. but at least my perception is that this shit is hard to track. I mean,
yeah,
people like
you can shut down a subreddit, but like people will find another other way. Ways to do this, yeah, if they want to.
And to that point, so, the subreddit was made private. And the Discord community for Wall Street Bets was shut down.
So another thing too is like, I'm extremely hesitant to be like, yeah, Wall Street Bets, let's go. Because you bet your ass there's a bunch of people doing it in bad faith or just like straight up shitty people. Like, they might be the ones who are like banding together to
stick it like, to the hedge funds.
Yeah, and then like make the hedge funds show they ass, like, that's cool and I appreciate that, but these aren't, I'm willing to bet that these aren't the people who be like, hell yeah, let's go get them, let's pull some money together and support like local initiatives and the DSA and shit like that. That's not happening. That's,
but they've transitioned to AMC now apparently. I don't know how that's going though.
Yeah, shit, more power to them, I guess. I don't know, but then, like, so, and there's a like a, obviously I don't know everything, so I'm like, okay, now that y'all got these stocks at like hella high prices, they bought low and sold high and in mass, so that's why I accelerated the stock prices. I don't know what the f- they do with that shit from here on out. Like,
the thing is, that's not the real value of GameStop, right? Like, they've inflated the stock price, but that's not the actual value of the business. And the thing about stocks, when you're talking about publicly traded stocks, like, those stocks have been, they were issued years and years and years ago. So that's not actually like giving the company money. It's not like, you know, you think of the stock market as like, oh, it's a way for people to invest in the businesses they think are going to do well. But like, that's not where companies are getting a lot of their actual money to invest in their business. You would need to do a particular thing to do that. Like, it's just all fantasy football.
It's not tied to real value, because like, what is GameStop doing to actually drive up that confidence, that actual stock price?
My contribution to the conversation is I quit working there last October. It was horrible. Damn.
Should have came through with some stock options though. You know what I'm saying?
I would be very surprised if they last more than a couple more years. They were really, really banking on the new console generation, like really hard. Like that was the push. But yeah.
Well, that's the thing, right? Like, GameStop's in the headlines now, but I imagine once this settles down, they're gonna be in the same spot they were a week ago.
No, 100%. Yeah, it's not gonna change GameStop's fortune, because that's not what stocks do. It's not like the stocks have given them all of this influx of cash that they can now use to somehow improve their business. Like, that's not what the stock market actually does materially for businesses. So yeah, like it's really just about either the lulls, which is a very common thing on Wall Street Bets. There's a lot, like, seriously, that it's a lot of like 4chan-y kind of language on there, and then part of it is obviously like sticking it to specific people, and power to them for sure. But that one,
if the average person on Reddit could do this, like, think about all the shit who, like, the people who play the game get away with. And it kind of ties into what Jake said about, like, do you think these people will be punished? Like, are they gonna crack down on this? And it's like, I just get carried away thinking about like the messed up shit that people aren't being punished for, and how easy it is to just play this. Like, because look, people are doing it, and it was not too hard for them to do.
I just think when it comes to scale, like the number of people who are participating in this is that, like, you don't see that every day, or you just, you won't get that very often.